great, thank you. I hope you can see everything. If not, just let her know as well. I just need to move that out of the way. So thank you very much, Laura. My name is Katia Petty, and I have been asked to discuss about our journey with Digimaps at the Academy at St. James. Before we start, though, I think it would just be really important for you just to have a little bit of a context about our school, and maybe it's something that maybe that you can relate to in your own setting as well. So my school is, let me just move that out of the way. That's annoying, it don't matter. Right, so we are a school in the centre of Bradford. We are an academy and we are a 1.5 form entry. So that means we have a year one class, a year one and a year two class, and a year two class, and it follows that pattern all the way up to year six. Our school has been on a huge journey in the past 4 years. So in 2017, we got a new head teacher, but prior to that, the school was put into special measures in April 2016, and it was honestly only a couple of days from being closed down, because that was the point that the school was at. There was not a curriculum embedded, there was not English, the learning behaviours weren't there, so actually geography was the last thing on every teacher's mind. And prior to our new head teacher coming into our school, the school has had 4 different head teachers in 9 months. So that just gives a little bit of a backstory about the journey that the school's been on. And then in that following September, I joined as well. Our school is in a really high area of deprivation, and as a result of that, we've got a really high proportion of SEND, of children who are disadvantaged, and more than the national average as well. We are in the top 10% of the most deprived neighbourhoods in the country, and that goes for health, crime and housing. So actually our school is really, really important for our children, just to give them the life opportunities that they actually fundamentally deserve. However, in the space of those 2 years, we had an Ofsted inspection, and we got 4 out of 5 areas for good. And actually, that is tremendous in such a 2-year period. And we are really, really proud of that. And some of you will be thinking, oh, well, actually, that means that we are due. Yes, we are absolutely due another Ofsted, which is great, but we'll get there. And we're actually really proud of the journey that we're on. So when I say that we have completely rewritten our curriculum, we have totally rewritten our curriculum, and obviously today I will be focusing on the geography part of it. And then I thought I'd just introduce myself, because I'm always a little bit nosy and I always want to know about the guest speakers as well. So this is myself. So I am in my 7th year of teaching. I am currently teaching year 2, and prior to that I taught year 1, year 3 and year 4 and other classes as well. This is my 4th year at the Academy at St. James, so I joined after our current head teacher just started as well. I've done my MPQML, I'm currently studying my MPQSL, and I also have a TLR as well. I've been geography lead for 3 years, and I'll get onto that in a minute as well. And this is my Twitter handle, I think that's what it's called. And we've also got our school Twitter handle, which you are more than welcome to follow, and because we're teachers and we love to steal and we love to borrow and we love to see what other schools are doing. But yeah, there's mostly my Twitter is just me and my dog, but you're more than welcome to follow as well. Now, our starting point, I am not a geography expert. So if you have just been given geography lead and you're thinking, I have no idea where to start, do not worry, that was me 3 years ago. And like I've said to the ladies before to this meeting, when I told my dad I was geography lead, he actually laughed and he said, don't do it. He said, just don't do it. He said, you don't even know where Huddersfield is. And he's right, I don't know where Huddersfield is. That's why we've got sat navs. However, my starting point was actually allowing our school to understand that geography is so much more than that. And that's why I didn't really like geography when I was at school, because I just thought it was from getting from point A to B, to know that you had to go on the M road, and I never knew any of that. So that's why we had to start with the question, why? Why is geography really important for our school? And this is the geography intent, and there's just a little snippet of it. And basically, I just really want to hone in on the fact that it's just about allowing children to be really active global citizens. We fundamentally want our children to understand that there is a life outside of our postcode. There is a life outside of BD15. And as I previously said, if we don't allow our children to have exposure to that, they will not get that due to the demographics of their area. And actually, that's unfair. That's really unfair for them. So that's why we want them to think like a geographer, to understand, oh, actually, if I'm learning about Kenya, I can go to Kenya. I can go to London if I'm learning about the Great Fire of London. I can go to Scarborough when we're learning about it in Stone Age. But actually, it's also about locational knowledge as well, which I'll get on to next. So that is how we started with the question of why. So from there, we had to make sure that our curriculum was purposeful and engaging. And this is just a really snapshot of our geography displays that we have seen all around our school. And actually, we've had to really, really build up the profile of geography to make it purposeful. And I'll keep saying that word purposeful, because we're not doing it to tick a box. We're all teachers, we're all professionals. We're not doing it for the big visitors that will be inevitable. We're doing it for our children. We're doing it to give them the best opportunity that they deserve. Now, I realised that our lessons needed to be well sequenced, knowledge and skills needed to be developed upon, which is a huge thing at the minute. Say, if you're learning something in year one, how is that supporting your knowledge in year three, then year three to year four, year five and year six? And then the outcomes needed to be purposeful and engaging. So here, this is a real snippet. This is my class actually this year. And this is where we use Digimaps for the maps. And we actually, and we were learning the text, The Golden Wonderflower, and the children actually used that in their English lessons to navigate and find the Golden Wonderflower, which was in the school area. But I just thought I'd give you a bit of context. So, resources. This is where we have to start off with. Atlases. We didn't have any atlases. We didn't have any globes. And this is where the point that we were at. And we also had a lot of training with Digimaps to allow us to understand how to use it purposefully for our children. From here, I've also very kindly given this by Sarah, I don't know if she's listening or not, from another school in our academy, where this is a skills progression document, and it has been split up into different areas of the geography: physical knowledge, locational knowledge, human and physical features. And then here, this is the area that I'll be focusing on next, is the using the maps, which I've pinpointed each point that we have used Digimaps to allow us to develop that progression. So in year one, we're just using a simple picture map to move around the school, which we've already done in our English. But then we go all the way up to year six, where obviously there is a more of a development of that. And hopefully you'll have seen how we have tried to show that progression in our geography curriculum, and by using Digimaps to show that. So start small. Start small. If you're just implementing Digimap, start small. Even if you just use it within you, even if you just use it within your team, even if you just use it within your key stage, and see how it works for you, and then you can provide examples for your staff. So that's what we did originally when I was in year three and year four, 2 years ago now. And this is when we were learning about the human and the physical features of Borneo. So as we can see here, there's some picture evidence of the children finding Borneo. They were looking at the physical features. We were comparing and contrasting to Ollerton, which is where our school is based. And actually then this links to, on the left-hand side, our progression document, where it says, I can begin to talk about the wider context of places, for example, the region and the country. So for that skills document, as a leader, I could tick that saying, okay, we've done that in year three and year four, and Digimaps has allowed us to do that. And it's allowed the children to also develop their ICT skills, and allow them to develop their geographical knowledge as well. And Digimaps has allowed all the children to access the geography curriculum. So this was last year in year one and year two, when we were doing the Great Fire of London. And they had to look at London and look at the landmarks as well. And it just brings it to life a little bit more. It just allows the children to take ownership over their learning, which I know that Judy will talk about later on as well. Now, this is why I've been asked to speak to you about our local area study. So we did start small in the sense that children were able to use Digimaps. We were able to locate Kenya. We were able to locate London. However, through the pupil interviews and pupil questionnaires, and through looking through the books and book scrutinies, we found that actually our children's locational knowledge was not suitable, and actually we were letting them down because they didn't know where they lived. We had many children saying that Bradford was a country, and it's certainly not. So then that's the point that we had to start with. So the first half term, so for autumn one, what we did is that we had a local area study. And this is a display that I've not tweaked it, I've not changed it. Anything that you're seeing is, we know what it's like in the school. This is exactly what it is. I've not put this specially up for this presentation. This is what it is. So we started off with basically with the question, where on earth is Bradford? And then this, and I'm going to show you some of the work that we have done to support that through the use of Digimap. So early years focused on our school. And I think it's really important that if your technology allows you, they actually just had this in the provision area as well. And the reception teacher said that the children were really good at saying, oh, they could say that the field, that there were fields, that they didn't live by the coast, that there were roads, that there were houses. And the more able children, they were asked if they could find their house, and then some of them would track their route to their house. And I'm not saying that some of your reception children would do that, and I'm genuinely not, but that was the point that some of our children were. But yeah, on the big screens, and then I know that she's printed them off, and their children have circled physical features that they could see. Obviously, we're not using the terminology physical features in reception. However, we're just getting them to expose to it. So then they're allowed, so they're seeing this format, which is allowing them to support their geography learning for when they're in year one. So it's starting in early years and it's going all the way up. It's not just starting in year four, it's starting right down in nursery. So then year one and year two, we branched a little bit out. We focused on Ollerton. And then on the left-hand side, this just refers back to that skills document about using maps. So what we did here is that we printed off a large scale map of the Digimaps for schools. It was by A3. And we actually planned a route on it. And as you can see here, the children actually went on the route around around Ollerton and around the estate as well. This was about 5 weeks of work, because we had to learn how to read a map. We had to learn how to follow a map. We went on the journey itself. And then after that, we actually located key landmarks as well, of the human and the physical features as well. And the children, I think they were better than me at understanding it, because they lived there, but they were really, really good. And then from that, our displays have been created, because we know how busy it is as a teacher when you get an SLT saying, where are your displays? Where's your curriculum displays? Where's your flashback? Where's all your understanding? Where's all your prior knowledge? So this is what is up in our provision area. So we've got a history and we've got a geography, and this is also in the key stage one area as well. And I think, I know Judy will touch on this as well, but the history, we have actually, when you can pull the scale along and you can compare and contrast maps over a time period. Well, our children really enjoyed that in history, because they could see how Ollerton has changed over the past 50 or 100 years. But then again, on this geography display, we've got the human and the physical features, we've got the map, we've got the landmark work that they also did. But then in the year one provision area, we have got the map that they tracked. We've also got the pictures of it as well. So it's making it really purposeful for them. It's not just a one-off lesson of just using Digimaps on the board. We print them off, we zoom them out, we zoom them in. We use a wide range of the maps so our children have access to that, basically. And so their understanding of map work is also developed as well. Then year three and year four focused on Haworth. And again, on the left-hand side, this links to our skills document. So hopefully you'll understand that we're just branching out. So early years focused on our school, we focused on Ollerton. Then year three, year four focused on Haworth. And again, and then actually one of their aims was to track a route from our school to Haworth, which is what you can see that little girl doing down there. And she was able to track it. And again, it's not like my dad when he's like, you don't know where Huddersfield is, and I know I need to go on this A road or whatever, whatever. It's just for them to understand that actually Haworth for us is only 20 minutes away. And it's about them having that deeper location knowledge, and Digimaps allowed us to do that. And then there's a nice little picture on the top right of how drenched they were, because again, field work is really important to us. We're a nature-friendly school. So by using Digimap to allow them to have a better understanding of the places that they're learning about, we don't care whether it's raining or sunny, we're out there doing it. Now, and then this again links to what I've just said in the year one, year two. When you've got SLT breathing down your neck, I need to get my displays up. This is all the children's work. It's nothing fancy, it's nothing special, it's just how children have done. And then again, how we have used the, how Ollerton has changed since the 1900s. It's a really nice tool to see basically how humans have impacted our space, obviously because there's more houses, there's more roads. And again, and then our outcomes have been purposeful as well, which I'll go in a minute. And this is another side of Haworth as well, another display in the year three, year four area where other maps are being used as well. Key vocabulary is up and actually it's making it like, and I'm going to say purposeful again, it's really purposeful and it's linking to everything that we're doing all the time in our school. And then year five and year six have focused on Bradford as a whole, but they also focused on Pittybeck. And then again on the left-hand side, this is the skills document. And then this is what, this was their outcome. So hopefully you see that there's been a progression in what we have been able to do. So in year one, year two, we created a brochure, a leaflet for why you should come to Ollerton. Year three and year four created an information booklet about Haworth. And then year five and year six produced this. So as you can see, we've got some key work. We've got some map reading work as well. We've got the physical and we've got the human features. I think it's really important to say that we are not the finished product. We still have a lot of work to do, but this was our starting point for location knowledge. And actually, we're really proud of how far we have come. And you might be ahead of us, you might be on the same journey as we are, but I'm just being as transparent and possible about basically how far we have come on. So our outcomes, we have a lot of field work and again, using the Digimaps to allow us to do that because we are so busy in the profession that if I just type it in, I can snip and print it off and it allows all the children to have access to it as well. Again, we've got some outcomes here as well, which was the year six and basically it's about allowing children to represent their own work and how they want to with everything that we've already taught them as well. But yeah, that's a very whistle-stop tour of everything that we've done. But like I said, we are not the finished products. And I just wanted just to show you just some examples of how we are using Digimaps to enhance our provision, but ultimately for the locational and local area study. So I will stop sharing. And if you do have any questions, please let me know.
Thanks, Laura, for that build up. I think that was an amazing presentation by Katia. And hopefully a lot of what I'm going to say is going to reinforce the amazing things that she's achieving with her pupils. I think the thing is that, as Katia said, Digimaps allows progression across a range of skills across the curriculum. And it becomes a resource pretty much like a dictionary or conventional atlas in your classroom if you choose to use it that way. So as all of this suggests, securing locational geography is a really keen requirement across the curriculum. And Digimap for Schools supports this. You could use a blank map of the world or a globe to locate places. Instead, using Digimap for Schools interactively on pupil laptops and interactive whiteboards, marking locations and saving maps to class files, it builds up a record, it builds up a resource that allows you to revisit concepts over a lengthy period of time. It means that you're looking at a wide locational geography across diverse places to develop and secure the forms of geographical knowledge which your pupils will need to access Key Stage 3 confidently. So knowing where's where, as Katia suggested, is absolutely critical, and it's critical across the curriculum, not just in geography. So it's important to identify opportunities to secure this across planned and the incidental curriculum. A lack of locational knowledge was the most significant complaint, and it was a complaint from secondary teachers feeding back to primary subject leads at a British Council Connecting Schools conference a few years ago. And this is still discussed when talking to key stage three teachers today. Digimap for Schools facilitates virtual feedback, field work, and ordnance survey coverage. And it includes historical mapping, as you've already seen. It supports physical field work, as you've certainly already seen. And it secures locational knowledge right from the foundation stage. The resource is inclusive and engaging. It allows you to record findings, evidence progression and skills through revisiting and actively applying prior learning, including IT skills, to every single new inquiry. So I'm just going to make a few suggestions as to how you can build Digimaps into the rest of your curriculum. And I'm going to start with history because that's probably the subject that I've used it in most often when I was still in the classroom. So here we were investigating the extent and the shape of the Roman Empire. And then we explored the journey from Rome to Britain. Now, I've done this before using conventional mapping, but here, working in pairs, Digimap for Schools makes the inquiry more engaging. It prompts discussion and it encourages peer support of mapping and IT skills. It also encourages pupils to support the teacher. Having done that, we then identified modern countries within our inquiry. We used the drawing tools to create a visual record, which was filed onto our Digimaps filing system and then printed off to go in books or on displays. Because again, as Katia has already said, I'm very keen on the idea that it's pupil work that goes on display, and Digimaps is just wonderful for that. The digital skills develop observation, coordination, and motor skills, the things that you don't get from using the conventional geographical resources. So still looking at history, here we're evidencing the point that it wasn't just the ancient Egyptians who lived in the ancient world. We've used the drawing tools to mark points on the route in our text and draw lines to identify the journey and look at how those people would have traveled at that time. So the inquiry is obviously based around the text, and that particular text has plenty of potential for geography within the history. It's inclusive because it develops the idea that all pupils can read pictures and photographs, and so they can, with scaffolding and practice, also read maps. It gives you a vehicle for assessment, not just an abstract written piece of writing, but recording the dialogue, keeping a note of what pupils say. For me, that's valuable assessment, and as I'll try and suggest later, it can suggest higher learning. So as Laura said at the beginning, there are a number of new overlays for Digimaps. I have not used these in the classroom. They're a new feature, but it strikes me that using the overlay that I've taken here, it's a striking visual to highlight the important information inclusively, and it will encourage debate. So here, in a similar way to catch you, I'm showing you some of the pupil displays that I had in my classroom. So using Digimaps as part of our historical inquiry allowed us to understand maps, including ordnance survey maps, which can be quite daunting in context. So we were reading and using grids to locate features as required at key stage two. We were reading contour lines to discuss the importance of the topography, looking at the Victoria Cave outside Settle, thinking about that Paleolithic lifestyle. Looking at the visual impact of the contour lines on the mapping in the classroom prompted some debate on our field work out in Swaledale prior to the pandemic. It was wonderful to hear comments such as, look at the contour lines. The contour lines are all around us as they were driving through what to us is local geography. Using the mapping allowed us to prompt an inquiry into the types of land associated with each phase of the Stone Age. So the Paleolithic cave, we could see it was on higher ground. We could look at the coastal location for the Mesolithic. And the Neolithic evidence showed us that the land that was used for the henges that was the point of our study is suitable for agriculture. And that moved us into the Bronze Age. And we did all of that through mapping. And the thing about Digimaps is that the drawing tools allowed us to create visuals which supported the inquiry. We looked into the possible purpose of the henges. When we found the distances between the henges, that prompted debate. And using Digimaps allowed us to secure a real local sense of place, not just for our immediate locality, but as Katia's suggesting, moving out from where you actually are physically, we were creating a sense of place right across the north of England, which for us is important. So this is an inquiry that I'm suggesting Digimaps would be incredibly valuable for. It's available on the Historical Association website with lots of other valuable resources. So like the Roman inquiry, I delivered it previously without having access to Digimap for Schools, and we tracked the trail using atlases and outline maps. Digimap for Schools provides a much more engaging and inclusive way of promoting independent learning within an inquiry. So now, if I were to deliver that inquiry again within the classroom, this is the sort of way in which I would use Digimaps. So I'd include the latitude and longitude overlay. It would be incidental here. I'm not looking to teach what goes on around the equator or the Tropic of Cancer, but I'm providing a visual reminder of the locational importance, and it's in context from our previous geography learning. So therefore, we're applying our prior learning in geography, our known knowledge, to move our history forward. And pulling on the prior learning around Saxon travel also supports the inquiry, and it develops the concept of global trade, which we'll have started to look at in the ancient civilizations and through the Roman period. And hopefully by doing this, we're going to counter this notion of the Dark Ages. So here in developing the inquiry, we're looking at how the burial was actually created at Sutton Hoo, and how the ship was taken from the river to the burial mound. In constructing the resource, I've created the aerial map first, and I'd suggest that that's the easiest way for pupils to do this as well, because it's much easier to locate the features on the aerial map. Once you mark the features on the aerial map, the markers stay and they transfer automatically to the other Ordnance Survey maps. So I've only placed those markers once on the aerial map, and then I've just switched the map types that I've been looking at, and the information has stayed. You can add photos to maps. On the Ordnance Survey mapping facility, there's photos are available. That's not the case on the global mapping. But you can also add your own easily. And I prefer to do that because my own personal photos give me an informed source. I know what I'm talking about because I was there when the photo was taken. So I'm using the historical inquiry to develop familiarity with aerial and ordnance survey mapping. And we'd have a look, we'd say this is actually the same map, and how does reading one support reading the other? Using Digimaps, we can also think about how the area has changed. So tracking back from today. So I'll show you in a moment a similar idea, which was based around a remembrance inquiry, which took us to Selby. And using the Digimaps historical mapping, it prompted the observation in one of my year five pupils that a railway line marked on an 1890s map is now the line of a main A road. Now that wasn't written down, it was in passing during conversation in the classroom, but I recorded that as evidence of high level history and high level geography. And we kept that evidence and it fed into her assessment profile. So that is the remembrance inquiry. There you can see pupils locating buildings from the past, which have now disappeared on the 1890s map. And that really looks, that's a really good resource for looking at changes in your local area. And then we ask the question, how did the people from our school, our tiny village school in North Yorkshire, come to be buried in Mozambique? And that led into looking and using Digimaps to support us to discover what his life was like before 1914 and what was the impact of World War I on his family. And all the pupils recognised that the main impact on the family, that there was, there would be no links between the family and where that soldier was buried. And it gave us the local locational opportunity. Where is Mozambique? We've tracked it. We've tracked the grave from our school. And we've looked at the journey that would be involved. And it's quite important, I think, when you're using Digimaps or any other geographical mapping resource, to always ask that question, where is what we're looking at in relation to our school? So again, we've got our Digimaps evidence as our pupils display, evidencing skills. And we're using Digimaps to develop fieldwork, including virtual fieldwork from Key Stage 1 right through to Year 6. And that familiarity secures progression in mapping. So on the left, you've got some work that is very similar to the work that Katia was talking about exploring your immediate local area with the foundation stage and Key Stage 1, and then moving into virtual mapping, which we did during lockdown to go on a trip to our nearest market town. Again, I'd taken the photos, so I knew exactly what was going on as they worked their way around that map. And again, I keep referring to capture, but as she really suggested very strongly, don't wait. So this is a recent Twitter post from Leyburn School showing the work that the early years teacher, Annabelle Watson, has done with her young pupils using Digimaps for schools. And I'm really grateful to her for giving me permission to use this. And you can see the recorded comments are providing assessment material and really bring life to that display. And importantly, the pupils are developing an awareness of a sense of place, their own local place. They absolutely get to know it through Digimaps for Schools. And as we've seen with Capture, if this is going on in EYFS, what are the skills going to look like in Year 6 if you've started using Digimaps at this point. So moving away from history, but not completely, because you always get the links. Referencing locational knowledge across texts and developing geographical vocabulary through those texts will have a positive impact on pupils' range and use of vocabulary across the curriculum, not just within individual subjects. So across the curriculum and during their daily lives. That's going to impact on their writing too. So using Digimaps for Schools as a research tool adds depth of knowledge to non-fiction writing. It allows the pupils to research, scaffold, and inform their writing themselves. So they're informing themselves, they're creating their own knowledge banks through their research. Thinking about maths, tracking journeys digitally in maths adds an extra dimension to timetables. How many times have we done maths problems asking us to think about when the bus arrives and when the bus departs, and we've got no idea where that activity is taking place? Use Digimaps to bring it to life. Other opportunities, I've already spoken about contour lines, calculating erosion, which is a really good tool for using with years 5 and 6. It's a very sophisticated concept, but thinking about the measurement around erosion. Time zones, we found that particularly useful and interesting when looking at fair trade and thinking about the reality of placing orders from the UK. Comparing data, particularly across places, particularly linked to climate, and now comparing populations. And by using Digimaps for Schools to support maths like that, you're embedding the locational knowledge. And it's being done incidentally, but it does become embedded. Geography is always in the news and it needs locating. All pupils can access Digimap for Schools at home with their parents or their carers, so it supports homework. And I've had pupils reporting to me that they plan days out at home and on their UK holidays that they're finally being able to plan. And they've used Digimaps and they've come in and they've shown me how they've done it. And then finally, inspiring the next generation. So this pupil supported me and his peers with the software. That meant that it raised his self-esteem, it boosted my confidence because I knew I had a specialist in the room who could support me, and it allowed the inquiries and the locational geography in our classroom to move forward. Thanks very much for listening.